Artyom, I knew! Behind you!
There is always one like you, a hero! You're not saving anyone, just like the others! So just...
Freeze!
Yes!
Let him go!
Don't kill me!
Now!
Remember what I told you. There was an
Enough chatter! Are you all right, Artyom? Thank God. Let's report to the Colonel. Dad, it's me.
Anna, are you okay? Where are you?
In the sick bay. Artyom found me. I need to catch my breath a bit. This whole situation, though. I thought we wouldn't see anything worse than that cult on the Volga. And that Silentius with his damn fanatics. But no, it appears there was still space for growth. We could have got killed there. We almost got eaten here. That bastard. Unbelievable. To think he used to be a doctor. Don't matter. We'll see what happens now. We did survive him, after all.
Saluted those ghouls! Some fucking arc. These monsters have made me. Like the Watchers in Moscow. Those keep people underground with their deceit. But these...
All right, but what do we do now?
I'll be damned if I know, Anna. No idea. Have you found anything, idiot?
Their defense sites, HQs... All the information is outdated. All links are long gone. Still, the ones that light up worked for at least a few years after the war.
What's down there?
It's Caspian 1, a comm center. There's one more just like that in Novosibirsk.
Are you going to drag us to some other bunker now?
I don't know, Anna. We have to make the decision together.
Careful, sir. Hate to interrupt, but it's getting quite hot here.
Did you get everything you could, idiot? We're leaving.
One moment. I'll finish breaking everything here.
Come on! Come on!
Okay, all done. I don't think you should have put it like that, Anna. It all worked out this time, didn't it?
It worked out. It really did. My concern is, what if next time it doesn't?
You're right, of course. But do you intend to live forever?
Of course not. All the more reason to strive and spend more time with what is allotted to me, with that guy over there. I've grown attached to him.
That I understand.
think I believed those pricks from Hansa? I believed that Moscow was controlled by the HQ, that we were under occupation, that we were still in war, that there were generals here giving orders. What an idiot, suka!
I will repeat my question. What do we do now?
Could we go back to Moscow? Tell them the truth about the war. The government.
They'll shoot us on approach. And even if we do break through, what can we do against Hansa? Who'd believe us with no proof?
What about going back to Volga? We could live there.
What do we do about the locals? They weren't exactly happy to see us there. Do we kill them all? Is anybody here up for that?
Back in Moscow, Artyom had been dreaming of finding a habitable place and building a colony there. Isn't it time we got to it?
The idea is good. But how do we find the place? Just keep traveling? The Aurora needs an overhaul. What do we do if it breaks down?
Satellites!
What satellites? You want to leave the fucking planet?
There's a satellite communication center on the Caspian Sea. It survived the war.
Oh. And if we gain access to the data collected by the satellites...
We won't have to travel randomly. Radiation level maps, even your regular satellite photos could really help us out here.
That's an idea.
What if there is something worse than cannibals there?
Could well be. But first, we're going to be really careful this time. And second, does anyone have any better ideas?
I don't.
Well, I guess we've got ourselves a new plan.
Artyom, shall we look for that place you wanted? Huh? Sound the horn, then!
Three months on the road, 3 months of constant trial. But after Yamantau, we are ready for anything fate can throw at us. Mere kilometers separate us from the Caspian One communication center. Will the maps within yield a spot free from radiation where we could finally settle in peace? I don't know. But what's left for us but hope? The desert is taking its toll. The crew suffers from heat and thirst, and the Aurora is not in her top form. We're out of coal and had to switch to burning available fuel. Old cross ties and twigs.
I'm not in love with this place. Nothing but sand and heat. I feel like shit here. Artyom, a car! I don't like this welcome either. Let's go.
They stopped in that village there. Looks like somebody lives there.
I see. How are the men doing, Demir?
Stepan is the worst off. The others are not so well either. Only us here are still in fighting shape.
Thank you. Ada, you and Demir reconnoiter the area. We need to find that damn bunker and hit the road as soon as we do.
We might have a slight problem with hitting the road, Colonel. And there's barely enough water in the boiler to make some tea. And we're all out of coal.
I see. We'll need to redress that, too. Anna, Demir,
One more task. Look for water and fuel.
Will do.
Get the men ready. We need to set up defenses.
Roger that.
See you soon. Just try to be careful, all right?
Artyom, we have to learn who those men with the car are. They do look like regular bandits, but we can't take risks here. The car was headed for the village. Looks like they have a comms relay there, and it should hold some info, which is just what we need now. Move out as soon as you're ready. Crest, can your rail car pull the train?
It might, but really slowly and not for too long. The engine is too weak for the weight, and we don't have much diesel left.
Well, if we had enough diesel, the Aurora wouldn't be needing any help.
How so?
Its firebox was originally designed for taking coal, but it also has high-temperature lining and liquid fuel jets installed.
Why didn't you say so before?
Because you never asked.
Is the injection system in working order?
I would need to check it.
Well, take Crest and run the checks.
Oh yeah, we'll take care of it, Chick Chuck, no problem. But that ain't giving us no diesel.
Judging how the locals drive around, it will be much easier to get our hands on diesel than coal around here.
What about the water? Can't run without it, but our tanks are dry.
Let's handle problems in the order of their appearance.
Hi, Artyom.
All clear.
Clear.
So, how'd you find the premises, idiot?
Looks like it used to house a ticket office and lockers. Full of garbage now. Could use some cleaning.
Damn, the sun is having a ball today.
Okay, set up the perimeter. You, get to the back of the train. Idiot, you get the engine. I'll clean the place up, then we'll bring Stepan. It's cooler than in the train.
Your word is law, my liege. Shall I commence now?
Commence!
Okay, I be off then.
Are you going out? Look here then. This is something I finished just now. Hollowed out a couple of T-Har bullets and filled them with explosive. Some explosive ammo right there. Now, you can do it yourself. It's quite simple. Don't forget to clean your guns regularly, with all this sand around.
Artyom! Wait, I'm coming with you. I think I could use a little walk right now.
Stopa, you can hardly walk. You'd better rest while it's not your shift.
Well, Artyom, I really do feel kinda under the weather now. Maybe next time.
You're right. Artyom and Amir are going out for a simple recon, not a fight.
And what if they get attacked?
Then they'll retreat back to base where you and Sam cover them. So you should rest now.
Yes. You're right, Katya.
Do you see that building with the antenna? The car went that way. Be careful out there, though. We don't know what to expect from the locals.
You made a mistake coming here.
I surrender! So, there's probably no chance to have a chat with the owners of this car. What a shame they're so silent. Though, had I had a car like this, I wouldn't want to give it up either. In my book, driving beats walking in this heat any day. Which reminds me, you've got a good test drive opportunity. While you were playing in this sandbox, I found some antennas. And the communication center should have them.
I think it's at that lighthouse, so you should head there.
The lighthouse is so huge, we can't miss it. I have to stay and keep tabs on the area for a while, but once I'm done, I might join you there. See ya!